Hey, what's going on guys? Rahul here from Tech Repro and welcome back to another episode. If you are looking for a simple step-by-step solution to clean install macOS Catalina on your Mac, then keep watching this video because in this video, you will learn how to create bootable USB for macOS Catalina and clean install macOS Catalina on your Mac computer. But before we get started, make sure that your system is supported with macOS Catalina. The general requirements for the macOS Catalina are 4GB of memory and 12.5GB of available storage. In the description below this video, I'll provide a link to the official website which provides you the list of all the supported models with the macOS Catalina. If you don't want to go to the website, here I'll show you all the supported models along with the years. The list says macOS Catalina can be installed on the MacBook 2015 or later, MacBook Air 2012 or newer, MacBook Pro mid-2012 or newer, iMac 2012 and newer, iMac Pro 2017 and newer, etc. If you are not sure about your Mac model, click on the Apple icon at the top left of your screen and choose About This Mac. Here you will get details about your Mac model. If your system is listed under this, then you will be able to upgrade your Mac to the macOS Catalina. Upgrading your Mac is so simple. If you don't want to delete any of your data, simply go to the download link provided below. Or you can also search for macOS Catalina in the App Store. As you can see, macOS Catalina is 5.7 GB in size and it may take a while to download. But once downloaded, you can upgrade your Mac from the installer application that appears after downloading it. This is pretty cool and easy way to upgrade your Mac to macOS Catalina, as you can upgrade your macOS Catalina without going through the process of creating bootable USB drive and all the installer stuff. But I usually don't recommend this method, because if you upgrade via App Store, this may leave some residual file which may create some issues later. So a better idea is to clean install macOS Catalina using a bootable USB drive. In order to create bootable USB, you must have at least 8GB of USB storage drive. If you don't have any USB drive with the size at least 8GB, you can check it on Amazon. I'll provide a link for some cheap and best USB drives in the description below. Alright. Now let's get ready to download it. Simply click here to download and this will open software update settings. Now if you click on upgrade now, macOS Catalina will start downloading. This may take a while depending upon your internet speed. I have a very slow internet connection and you can see how bad it is. So in the meantime, let's check out what new features macOS Catalina has got. As you can see, it has got a brand new auto dark mode, dynamic desktop wallpaper, and some brand new apps as well. For example, Apple TV has finally come to the Mac. Apple has killed iTunes in macOS Catalina, so you won't see iTunes, but you can still find your music in Apple Music app, podcast in Apple Podcast app, and movies in Apple TV app. So you are getting three brand new apps in place of the one buggy iTunes. Then there is Find My app, which allows you to find your devices and your friends on a single app. And don't forget, now your favorite iPad apps are also coming to your Mac. Well, there are many more features and changes in macOS Catalina, and I'm not going to go into detail about them. So rather than taking your more time, I'll stop the recording and fast forward this and come back when download completes. Alright guys, macOS Catalina has finally been downloaded and now ready to install. But in order to install it, we need to create a bootable USB. So once you have downloaded macOS Catalina, you are ready to create bootable USB. In order to create a bootable USB for macOS Catalina, first of all, open Disk Utility. You can search for Disk Utility using Spotlight Search. If you are a complete beginner, let me tell you, there are two ways to open Spotlight Search on your Mac. First one is by pressing Command button and Spacebar simultaneously. And another way is by clicking on the little search icon on the top right corner next to the Siri icon. Once Disk Utility opens up, now plug in your USB flash drive. Check whether it is available in the Disk Utility or not. If you can successfully locate your USB drive, you are ready to proceed to the next step. But if you are unable to locate your flash drive in the Disk Utility, then try re-plugging your USB. The next step is very important. Make sure to backup all the important data from your USB drive to another hard drive or computer to avoid any loss. Because backing up data to the same computer which you want to clean install will erase everything, including your backup. However, if you are using a brand new USB drive which has no data, then you don't need to worry. Once the backup process completes, come back to the disk utility and click on the drive which you want to make bootable for clean installing macOS Catalina. Now go ahead and erase it using format macOS extended journaled and rename it as my volume. Naming it my volume is not so important. You can name it anything as per your choice, but make sure you remember what you have named because you will need it later. By the way, if you don't want to go through the hassle of remembering and recalling it later, I would recommend you to name it as I have named so that you can copy what I am doing. Now click on erase and wait until the erase process is completed. When erasing process has completed, click on done and make sure that USB thumb drive is formatted as macOS extended journaled. Awesome! Now we can close the disk utility. Once you have closed the disk utility, you can also quit the macOS installer. To quit macOS installer, go to the menu bar and select quit macOS. You can also close it by right clicking on the icon in the dock and select quit. And there is a shortcut as well, which is command plus Q. Q stands for quit. Now the next step is to go to the finder window and then go to the application folder. Within the application folder, you need to search for the macOS installer. Once you find the macOS installer, right click on it and choose show package contents. This will show the contents folder. Now double click on the contents folder and this will show many folders. But you have to double click on the resources folder to open it. Within the resources folder, you need to find create install media. Once you have found it, leave the window open and now open terminal by searching in the spotlight search. When you are on the terminal window, type sudo sudo followed by pressing the space bar once and go back to the previously opened finder window. Now you need to select and drag create install media over to the terminal window and then release it. Now type dash dash volume, then space. Again, go back to the finder window and from the menu bar, select go. Then click on the go to folder. There is also an alternative shortcut which is shift plus command plus G. But this shortcut will only work when your finder window is active. This will open a box and when the box appears, type /volumes and hit return or click on the go. Here a new finder window will open up with all the available volumes including your external USB drive. If your USB drive is not listed here, try reinserting it. As soon as you find your USB drive listed here, click on your USB drive. Since we have named it My Volume, here it is My Volume USB drive. However, in your case, it may vary depending upon the name you have entered while formatting the drive. Click on it and drag it over to the terminal window just like this. Now we can close the finder and we will go back to the terminal window. Within the terminal window, now press return button on your keyboard. Now you will be asked for the administrator password. Simply type in your admin password. This will be the same password which you usually enter while logging into your Mac. When you have entered your password, it will say ready to start. To continue, we need to erase the volume. So we are ready to proceed. If you wish to continue, then type Y and hit return on your keyboard. It will start erasing the disk. Alright, now the disk is being erased and it may take up to 5 minutes. After the disk has been erased, the system starts copying the file to the USB. This may take some time depending on the writing speed of your USB drive. That is why I recommend a USB drive with faster writing speed. Make sure you check the link in the description below in case you need one. Usually it takes 20 to 30 minutes, so let the process happen and relax until the process is done. In case it is taking more than 30 minutes, then you should start the process again from formatting the drive. Alright, now we have made our USB drive bootable and it is finally ready for clean install of macOS Catalina. But just in case if you want to ensure that you have done everything right, go to the finder window and check for the USB drive. Here you will see that your USB drive name would have changed to install macOS Catalina. And that's the green signal to proceed. So we are ready to proceed because the bootable USB installer is ready to go. But before moving further, I want to remind you, please create a backup for your system. Clean installing macOS Catalina will delete everything that you have on your Mac. And I don't want my comment section to be flooded with your complaints. So guys, precautions first. Okay, when you have your backup ready, let's jump into the next step. Turn off your Mac and insert the macOS Catalina bootable USB drive that we have recently created. Now power on your Mac and as soon as the screen turns on, press and hold the option button. This will show you the list of bootable drives you have currently on your Mac. First one is Macintosh HD, which contains the macOS that I'm using. And the second one is bootable drive named Install macOS Catalina. Since we have to clean install, we will select Install macOS Catalina and hit enter. Let the installer load and in the meantime, why don't you subscribe to Tech Repo channel if you haven't already, because we bring cool tips, tricks, tutorials and hacks related to technology. Anyways, I'm going to fast forward this because I don't want to let you wait for a while. Okay, here it comes. macOS utility is here. In order to clean install, we have to format the main drive. To do so, click on the disk utility. Once the disk utility opens, here you will see all the drives that are connected to your Mac. Select your drive by clicking on the name of your drive. For me, it is Macintosh SD. You may also find your drive based on the capacity, as I have 128GB SSD. Now click erase and from here, choose the format type. macOS Extended Journal would be the nice option. Since I have SSD on my Mac, so I'll choose APFS file system. The reason why I'm choosing this, I'll let you know in a moment. But before that, let's know what APFS is. APFS is popularly known as Apple File System, which is the default file system for Mac computers using macOS 10.13 or later. And the reason why I'm choosing this is, Apple recommends APFS for recent Mac computers running on macOS 10.13 or later, because APFS features strong encryption, space sharing, snapshots, fast directory sizing, and improved file system fundamentals. According to Apple, while APFS is optimized for flash or SSD storage used in recent Mac computers, it can also be used with older systems with traditional hard disk drives, SSD, and external direct attached storage. Now go ahead and click erase. Wait for a few seconds till the format process is completed. And once the formatting is done, go back from the disk utility. Now it's time to install all new macOS Catalina on your Mac. So click on Install macOS and this has led us to the installer window. Simply allow the installer to proceed by clicking continue. And now you will get software license agreement terms and conditions. If you want, you may read. After that, hit agree. And again agree. Next, you need to select the drive in which you want to install the macOS Catalina. Since we have formatted this drive named Macintosh HD, so we will select this one and click install. It will start the installation process. This may take up to 20 to 30 minutes. So wait for a while and have some coffee, because your Mac will soon be ready with brand new macOS Catalina. So that's how you can install macOS Catalina on your Mac. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like, share and subscribe. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments below. But before you comment, follow the instructions properly. That way, you will save my time as well as yours. Thanks for watching. I'm Rahul signing off, and I'll talk to you in the next video.